You may remember a few months back I took a look at the pros and cons of geothermal energy, in other words tapping into the potentially limitless heat energy that's available beneath the surface of the earth. We looked at very large systems providing grid scale energy like the one in Iceland, and very small domestic systems that provide just enough heat to run an individual home. The biggest drawback of those domestic systems is that they're often fitted retrospectively to existing houses, and as a result they can be prohibitively expensive. Just like every other element in the building industry, a geothermal heating system is far easier and less expensive to install if it's done before the house is built in the first place. That way all the architectural and technical specifications can be designed correctly right from the get-go. And sure enough, there are plenty of examples of far-sighted, environmentally conscious self-builders who've done just that for their own house projects. But even with this level of planning and preparation, installing all that underground infrastructure just for a single home still lacks the economy of scale achieved by utility-sized operations. So perhaps there's a potential gap in the market here. What if a system could be implemented that did have similar economies of scale to those enjoyed by grid-scale operators, but that still retained the direct flexibility and control enjoyed by individual homeowners? Well, that's exactly what's happening in a housing development called Whisper Valley, just outside Austin, Texas in the US. And it looks like it could be a blueprint for developers all over the United States and the wider world. Hello, and welcome to Just Have a Think. You folks across the pond will know much better than me that large-scale residential and mixed-use housing developments, which can include thousands of new homes, are common in the United States. They're called master-planned communities. And in many ways, this one in Whisper Valley is a fairly typical example. When it's all finished, it'll comprise 5,000 houses of various sizes, 2,500 apartments, and 2 million square feet of commercial space, along with schools, community buildings, and even a wastewater treatment plant catering for 30,000 residents. The whole thing will be the size of a small town, covering a total area of 2,000 acres. The big difference is that all the buildings on this development will have the potential to produce as much electricity as they consume, thanks to a groundbreaking geothermal and solar power system provided by a company called EcoSmart Solutions. A geothermal exchange loop field, known as a geogrid system, provides the bulk of the thermal energy for heating and cooling and even domestic hot water. Unlike large geothermal systems that use high temperature sources, typically from deep locations within the earth, for electricity generation, geothermal exchange loops, in combination with ground source heat pumps, provide a highly efficient renewable energy technology that pumps thermal energy from the earth directly into the buildings in the winter and then reverses that flow in the summer. That's combined with ultra-efficient appliances and smart thermostats to reduce the energy requirements of each home by about 65%. And all those smart home technologies can be controlled by an app and portal that can integrate more than 10,000 different devices or products with an energy monitoring platform from a company called Sense that enables homeowners to have complete control over how they allocate their energy expenditure. It's a very clever setup, and plus, as a nice little aside, and in a rare example of common sense and lateral thinking, while EcoSmart have the trenches open to put in the geothermal pipework, they also run fibre optic cables in there too, which provide gigabit per second internet speeds for every single house. The geothermal system works in conjunction with rooftop solar panels, and in some cases with home battery storage systems, to manage electricity use and to provide backup power in the case of a power outage. EcoSmart call that a power resiliency package. The installed solar PV systems on each house only need to be relatively small because of the lower electricity demand as a result of the geothermal system. And all the homes are still zero energy capable, which means that homeowners enjoy very low or even zero utility bills with what's called smart energy behaviour. The geothermal system itself uses polyethylene pipes with a 50-year warranty. Each home is equipped with its own ground loop in conjunction with a highly efficient geothermal heat pump. To take advantage of the Earth's 22 to 23 degrees Celsius year-round temperatures in Austin, the vertical ground loop is inserted into a 350-foot deep borehole. Water passing through the pipe absorbs or emits heat energy depending on the season. The heat pump then uses that to either heat or cool the home. What makes Whisper Valley's geothermal system innovative is that each home's vertical ground loop is networked into the main geogrid communal underground system. That's 5 miles of pipework with an energy centre that provides central pumping, ancillary heat rejection through cooling towers, and advanced monitoring and control, enabling the entire development to share and optimise thermal energy. That's very useful because it provides a bit of resiliency if anything goes wrong with an individual borehole, and it also means that the geothermal capacity of an individual home doesn't need to be sized to the home's peak load. And the entire geogrid for each development phase is installed before the first home is even under construction. That makes it very easy for the builder in Whisper Valley to simply hook up to the geogrid, very similar to connecting to the water supply. Heat is extracted from the boreholes between December and early March, so there's ample thermal capacity to absorb the heat rejection from the homes during this summer and autumn, when the ground source heat pumps gradually increase the borehole temperatures back up again. The central monitoring software controls the performance of the underground system and the cooling tower to ensure that the geothermal water doesn't exceed the maximum temperature and to get the most efficient performance out of the ground source heat pumps. Did I mention it was very clever? EcoSmart say that as they gain empirical data from the operation of the geogrid system, their engineers will be better able to predict its thermal dynamics to build in improvements as each phase of the development unfolds. They're working to an industry standard benchmark called the Home Energy Rating System, or HERS, which is set up by the US Residential Energy Services Network, or ResNet. The target for homes on the Whisper Valley development is a HERS rating of 25 or lower. That means the building would consume 75% less energy than a standard conventionally built, heated and cooled new home. The lower the number goes, the better the home efficiency is. And the lowest HERS rating so far achieved in Whisper Valley is 7, which is pretty good. Homeowners are currently eligible for tax incentives on the geothermal installation, as well as their home's solar panels and batteries. That allows them to write off 26% of the value of both systems, which can be anything between $6,000 and $15,000, depending on the size of the home. EcoSmart then charge each household a small fixed monthly fee of between $50 and $70 to pay for all their services. As of May 2021, Whisper Valley had 207 occupied homes and another 6 under construction as part of the full 237 homes in Phase 1. The infrastructure for Phase 2 is complete, and that'll be 267 more homes. Phases 3 and 4 will add a further 363 homes during 2021 and 22. On average, the builders sell about one house per day, and the demand for EcoSmart homes is proving to be very high. In total, there are a brain-bending 51 phases on the development, with an estimated final completion date of 2035, which makes me very glad I'm not a project manager anymore. But if you're an American watching this, then you'll be pleased to know that most of the components of the geogrid systems are manufactured and assembled in the USA, which means yet another example of an opportunity to create the decent, well-paid jobs that'll be such a crucial element, not just of President Biden's ambitious green recovery program for America, but of the entire global transition to a cleaner, more sustainable future. No doubt you'll have views on this initiative too. If you do, then jump down to the comment section below and leave your thoughts there. That's it for this week though. A big thank you, as always, to the people who make these videos possible by supporting my work via Patreon. They allow me to remain completely independent and they enable me to keep all these videos absolutely ad-free. You can join the team at Patreon and get the opportunity to exchange ideas and information with like-minded folks, plus watch exclusive monthly news updates from me and have your say on future programs in monthly content polls by visiting www.patreon.com/justhaveathink. And you can hugely support the channel absolutely for free by subscribing and hitting that like button and notification bell. Dead easy to do all that. You just need to click down there or on that icon there. As always, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week. And remember to just have a think. See you next week.